Hey Kitchen Commandos! Today we are tackling the kitchen in this series of decluttering and organizing our space. But before we unleash our inner neat freaks, let's discuss inner emotions. Decluttering and organizing, I don't know, some people just love cleaning, love decluttering and doing all this, but there's a lot of people that don't. And there's a lot of emotions too. I want to address a group of people right here, right now. And those are the people that struggle with depression and really need a boost from somebody who can just encourage you to start simple. So in these YouTube videos, we show you from start to finish, and you know, we speed up things 900 times so that, we're just working fast and we're doing all this stuff and we got all this energy. But I know there's something on my heart today that I really want to address, and that's with people, especially in the wintertime, who deal with depression and find it really difficult to get motivated and get into this task. It's not just about decluttering a physical space, but it's about decluttering the weight off your shoulders. If you're watching this and you're feeling a weight of heavy fog on your shoulders, I just want you to know you're not alone. We've all been in that place where even organizing a small space feels like climbing Mount Everest. So today I'm here, I want to encourage you and I want to inspire you to help you to get to that place where you begin, where you start. And I want to add something here. I want to add a prayer for people that find this very, very difficult to begin. Not only to begin, but as I'm going through this process, I know the emotions that come up. Some of them are just, oh my gosh, I want to quit right now. I want to walk away from this. Why did I start this? This is horrible. Everything looks worse. I should have just kept it all behind the closed cupboard doors, okay? So I want to start right here with prayer. And if you don't want to hear the prayer, if you don't want to pray with me, just skip over 30 seconds and go on with the video. But I want to start here because I know this helps a lot of people. So just before you start, and if you're feeling those emotions, just pray with me. Father in heaven, this is something that I really want to do. I know it's going to help me to feel better. I don't necessarily feel like doing it, but I know that it's something that when I'm finished, it will bring me a lot of joy. Father, I just ask you to help me. Give me the perseverance to get through this task. Send your angels and heaven's host to make things easier while I'm going through this process. I know that I could do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Thank you. Amen. Okay, so let's get on with today's task. So as we start, I want you to think about just taking one step at a time. Now, this video may be done in so many minutes, may be done in an hour of your time, where it may take me 3, 5, 8 hours. It may take me one day. It may take me 2 or 3 days to finish this task, right? Because I have a lot to go through. But it doesn't matter how long you take it. If you were to take one section, if I'm doing, say, pots and pans, and it took me 10 minutes to do pots and pans and decide what was going and what was staying and to reorganize that, that may take you one day. That may be a section of one of your days, right? And that's good. That's the beginning. And then watch the video through another section that I go through and say, you know what, I'm going to do that section of my kitchen today and just do that one cupboard, that one drawer, that one space, and just get it done and then go on with the next day. And this isn't just your kitchen, but if you go through my other videos, my master bedroom or my closet videos, same thing. That did not take me one day. I gave myself a week to do my bedroom. I gave myself a week to do a closet. And for other people, that could have been done in one day, all right? So I just invite you to join me here and to be encouraged to finish the task. So come on, let's get started. Okay, so for today, I know what I have to do. I have some kind of vision. I've been trying out some different things. I bought something for the end of my counter over here. You see it over there. And I know that there are some things that I really do want to declutter, and I've left them where they are because I thought, well, if I'm decluttering day by day and throwing these things out, come time for a YouTube video, there's not going to be anything left. So I'm going to get my beans out of the pot, and then I'm going to start with, now this is something that might help you begin too, is that you have to make a plan. Let me move this back. Okay, you have to make a plan. Now, where am I going to start? Are my drawers, are these drawers, is this a priority where my cutlery and everything is? Well, I know that that's not a priority because these drawers are pretty much, well, my one cutlery drawer is a mess, but the other drawers really aren't, and they're not going to be difficult. But I know that this part here of my kitchen, this is the part that really needs the decluttering, and these cupboards right here. So what I'm going to start with is, oh, I also know that under here needs to be done, and this pretty much is okay. The things that are in here are on drawers, and there's things that are there because I use them on a regular basis. They're very easy to grab these things when I need them. That's my other Instant Pot, my Magic Bullet. Things that are put in here have always stayed pretty much organized. It's what fits there and nothing else goes there. Pots and pans. Yeah. Underneath my stove, all these cupboards here are just, they need to be done. So that's where I'm going to start. So I'm going to start by putting all my dishes away. I'm going to take the beans out of the Instant Pot, get that tidied up, and then I'll get into the cupboards. So I have problems with fruits and vegetables, like my cat getting into the avocados last night, even though this lid was on there, it was on loosely, but he got it off. Bananas. Fruits and vegetables that I buy, bread, no place really to put bread, and I don't want a conky bread box anywhere, because I really don't have room for bread box, and it wouldn't really look aesthetically pleasing to me, so I bought this. Now there was a lot of different kinds, styles of fruit and vegetable baskets that were really nice and curvy and, you know, nice design. Some of them were more straight designs, but there was just something about this. Now what I wanted to do here was to put baskets up here so that my cat couldn't get to anything, because he used to get into bread too, so he hasn't done that in a long time, and hopefully he's not into that again. Otherwise, I don't know, I'll have to come up with something else. But we've left bread on the counter for months now and he hasn't tried to get into it. So This is what I bought. Now, is this for a kitchen? Well, no, it's not advertised for kitchen. It has wheels that go on the bottom. And you could get a 3-tier, you could get a 5-tier. And I just wanted something here that would take care of all my stuff. So I have, let's take a look. I've got vinegar here that's been sitting here, cider vinegar, for months, and that's going to keep going. It's still not strong enough. I've got some garlic that I don't keep in the fridge. I've got my ginger that's growing. I've got my teapot that could go somewhere else. I've got these beautiful bowls here, like fruit bowls or punch bowls or whatever they're for, and a basket to hold things, but it's just taking up space in my counter. And then I end up throwing my used lids and rings and things from opening canning jars, I throw them in here. So this has got to go out of here. So the two things that I want to keep here, I thought of throwing this under the kitchen sink, but I don't like that. I did that for a couple of days when I was trying to figure this out, because if I put something nice and pretty here, to put this up here, because my juicer was here before and I would just hide it behind my juicer and it would stand up against the wall here, and I'd have my juicer brush for cleaning my juicer and stuff. And then I've got other things going on here, like this is my vanilla. Don't know where to put this. I'll probably put this in a container somewhere. I've got my Instant Pot. That is my smaller 6-quart Instant Pot. I was thinking of putting that here but it looks kind of out of place. And I also have the coffee maker. Now, the coffee maker, I didn't buy for me. It was actually my mom's. I bought it from my mom a couple years ago. And since then, she's moved to a different residence and she doesn't use a coffee maker. So I took it back. But we don't really use a coffee maker. And if I wanted a coffee maker, I would have bought one. But now I feel like we should keep it. And so, you know, once in a while, we'll put like decaffeinated coffee Keurig cups in it and stuff. And you can also do single cups, you know, of drip coffee and things like that. So, okay, we'll keep it. But I don't really have a spot for it on my counter, and I don't have a spot for it under my counter. And if we're going to use it, I'm not putting it in and out of a pantry. Like, who does that with a coffee maker, right? So I found something that is working here, and I want to show you. And the reason why I'm doing this now is because I figured this out last night. Because it came on Amazon. I ordered this 2 days ago and it came yesterday on Amazon. And so this is what I'm doing here. Now, so I need spot for this, and then I'm going to put my vinegar behind here. And I'm putting it on a trivet so that it doesn't easily slide off. I have an outlet here that I have a little nightlight on at nighttime, and also that outlet. So if I'm using electric, if I'm using my blenders or my Instant Pots and stuff, that's still going to be easy to use the outlet. Now, bread. So I can put my bread here. My bananas. In the summertime, we always have produce coming out of the garden, and it's always on top of my counter, or it's in one of these bowls or baskets, and it just starts lining up and it's getting cluttered. So using vertical space here is really going to help me a lot. And then for these mats, I was like, oh, I could put them behind here, you know. But you know what? You know what I realized? Look at this. Look at this. Well, actually, I'm going to take them apart. I usually use the red one. They fit right under here. Look at that. Like, when I realized this last night, I was like, that's amazing. I've got to tell people. So the avocados are going to go up top. Actually, if I put them here, I was just thinking if the cat can get in them. Yeah, he'd get in them there. I need to get some kind of a container that maybe has a mesh top to it. Because if I show you in this video what I found this morning, I was not impressed. And I got my garlic and my ginger. I could just leave these up here too. My vanilla and my teapot. So my teapot can go somewhere else, but I can also just kind of set it in here. And I'll just put my vanilla in here for now. So a lot of times if we're getting pita bread or buns or wraps, anything like that, I usually throw them on top of my Instant Pot over here. So I'll throw the package of wraps over here, and they're just sitting here. I'll throw the bananas on top of here. And that's really not working for me. I just feel like I've got a lot of counter space. Well, yeah, I do, but I've got too much stuff on top of them. So then I've got my cucumbers. So my cucumbers, if we don't see them, we don't use them, but I can put my cucumbers in here, and tomatoes, things like that. So look at this. This looks really good. And then for the coffee maker, watch this. Coffee maker, perfectly there, right beside the sink. Easy. I don't have to actually, because I was thinking, should I put the Instant Pot here and the coffee maker over there? Because it really like gave me more space on that counter, but I don't use that counter for a lot, except for if I'm canning. But this here, it just kind of sectioned this off to a nice little nook. And then, instead of putting these little Keurig things in here, trying to find a spot for them, I can put them in here. I could put a little dish here. I could just add a couple there. I could use this. I could put our supplements in something like this now and put this away because there's no spot for this. I can't even fit this into one of my cupboards. It doesn't fit. It's too big. So it has to stay on a counter somewhere. So, you know, that's my other option. Here, I'll throw it in here for now. Oh no, I don't like it there. But anyways, I'll throw that there for now because it's gonna go in here later on. Okay, so is that it? Yeah. And now my space over here, there's a lot more space here. I used to have a big wooden block for my knives that came out to here. You know the ones, right? That are have all your steak knives in there, and then you put all your... And that was taking up too much space. It was a light-colored wood. I didn't like it. I had it for like maybe, I don't know, 30 years. And I bought this one, and I like how less space it takes, and just the knives that I need are in here. So now I gotta get rid of this, which I will do. But for now, my point is, see, squirrel, right? Look how nice this looks. And this gives me area to dry dishes if I want to. My drying mats are right here that I could pull out. Very convenient. And I really like it. And I mean, you would never think, oh, that's an office organizer, right? It's gonna work out really well for us. So now let's get on with some of these cupboards and declutter. Okay, so this is getting a bit out of control here. And I keep my baking sheets down here. I found a good place for them. I've got pizza pans under here. And that works okay. This one here. Now, the reason why I have so many of these is because I was doing, like small meals, freezer meals. And instead of using tin foil, I just bought multiple stainless steel. So that's what I use if I want to do freezer, bulk freezer meals. I use these instead of tin foil. Now, going through a bunch of these pots and pans, I've been investing in a lot of good quality cookware. And I don't like Teflon, and I don't like nonstick surfaces with the coating. And even though this is the rock, and it was ceramic, it still does stuff where it doesn't stay nonstick, and you really shouldn't use metal in them, and they do scrape. So I found a problem with this, and then I decided, you know what, I'm going to start investing in really good stainless steel cookware, and you know what, I'm just going to get rid of these. I don't use these anymore, so they're going in the garbage. This is a broken lid, but sometimes I really needed it for my stock pot, but I have other lids now, and that would fit over that large stock pot, so I'm going to toss this also. So the same with this, like I could see where there have been little lines of scrapes in here. This is still in good condition, but I don't use it anymore. We use our cast iron and we use our stainless steel, so I don't use it anymore. And I don't trust the coating. I don't care what anybody says. Like, to me, there's something else in that. That's not just ceramic. That's my splash mat. Okay, what else do I got? Oh, I didn't even know I had more pans back here. Look at that. You could see the metal in there, but don't use it. Now this is ceramic. Makes this Okay, so that's our compliments. I think this is a ceramic. This is their ceramic coating pan. And this is looks practically new, doesn't it? But I'd never use it. And I could say to myself right now, but it's almost new. I'm going to donate this. I'm going to donate this one. I didn't think I had anything to donate in there. Okay, so I can... Now I could say, okay, you should deep clean these. There might be some specks down here of stuff, but I'm not into that right now. Right now I just want to declutter and get rid of trash. And I don't think I need this anymore because I don't have anything non-stick in there. That's garbage. Now, lids. See my mess here? Look at this. This usually goes together quite well. But I do always have this extra lid. This one here is an extra one. This one goes with this pot. This lid is always extra, and I'll use it on my frying pans and stuff. But it is extra, and I never had room for it. So I'm going to put it here. I'm going to leave this here because digging for it down there, I could never find it. So I'm going to leave that one there. And then what else do I got here? These are my stock pots, which are fine there. These pots I use all the time. I have my smaller one inside. I got this pot because this one, the handles were loose on, and my husband said he didn't want me using it anymore. But we took the handles off, and I find I still use it for things, so it's still here. And now I can organize that there. Everything's really easy for me to grab my pots when I do this. So I really like these drawers. And now I got all this extra space down here, which is going to work well for me. So that's good. Just got some extra lids, extra glass lid. I'm done. One task done. Alrighty. Now in here, this is a nightmare for me down here. I keep my, what is this for? Is this a turkey lifter or roast lifter? Yeah, that's probably what that is. Probably used it once. I use these. This is for my Instant Pots, my trivet for one of my Instant Pots, but I never find it down here. It really shouldn't be down here. But it's probably here because I don't have, or maybe somebody misput it down there. Maybe I don't use it a lot, but definitely want to keep it. Oh my goodness, look at this. So this is my ceramic cast iron. I don't know if I want to keep it. It's heavy as all heck, okay? This is so heavy. The nonstick has gone on it, and I'm only going to keep it because it's cast iron? I don't know. I'm having a hard time getting rid of this, but I put it down here because I stopped using it. So I think I'm going to get rid of it. And... it's so heavy, and if I was to get another cast iron, I would have the one with the handle here because I'm finding it really difficult working with these. This is heavier than my regular cast iron that we use on a regular basis. And I never thought I'd get rid of this, but I'm getting rid of it. I just used that for small chicken the other day. I had to dig in here to find it with all that stuff. Here's some more cast irons. That one's greased. Now these are okay for camping and stuff. I don't know about these. I'll put them up here for now. This one here. Out. And then I keep my original, this is my burner for my stove. I have, this is the original, well, it's not the original, because my original has a sensor, but this is a regular one for my stove, but I have one that's lifted up higher for canning on my element right now, so I just switched those out, so I will keep that down here. Now I can put this down here, and I can put Now, I think this should really go with my roasting rack, but I don't use it very often. It would just get in the way. So I will put this on the bottom. These I use on a regular basis. I'll put this on the bottom. Oh, this needs to be cleaned out. But I'll worry about cleaning on my cleaning day. Right now I'm decluttering. It'll be so much easier to clean this because I only have a few things to take out. Put these with my Instapot stuff. And then these, I don't know. They're not in the way down here, but I think I should be decluttering them because look at this. You know those commercials where like, there's a commercial where the lady's like, trying to use her oven, she has to take out like 1,001 things out of her oven. This is my oven. Besides the fact that it needs to be cleaned, I know that. This is from making bacon in here. And we stopped doing that. We started doing it on the barbecue, but all winter we've been doing it in here. So I've got my regular cast iron, use this all the time. And then I store it here. And then this is our small cast iron we use all the time. And then I have a couple of stainless steel that I use now. This is my wok. And it takes up a lot of room and I don't have any space for that. So that usually ends up in my oven. And then this is a large lid for my large pots. So, and then this is on my stove right now, but this is the new stainless steel I got. So when I want everything off, this is how I store my pans. Now if I could store them underneath and had room underneath, that would be better. But I can't come up with a solution for this. Oh, there might be room in here now for some of these pans. Yeah. Oh, I should try that. Even this lid. So, even if I just had these three that I had to remove on a regular basis when I'm using my oven, I could do that. But I should figure this out. And that's just melted butter in there. Okay. So now there's this. Now can I store some of those pans in there? Yeah, probably can. Hold on a second. Okay, so there's all my pans. These are the pans that we use on a regular basis. Small, large cast iron, medium and small of these. And then I've got this big lid here that I want to be able to grab when I need it. The wok is another story. There's no space for wok in this kitchen. So to leave that in there or to put it in the pantry, that would be my only other option. So I've got, so I've still got this. I wonder if this lid fits down here. I'm going to be so happy because I couldn't find a place for it. Is that going to fit? I don't use this often. I just want to keep it because when I do need it, it's there. Oh my goodness. It's fitting. I had to check to see if I was actually recording because like that to me is like wow, this thing took up so much space and I had this space down here, but those pans that I didn't use were taking up that space. I can even just put this upside down here, makes it even nicer. Look at that. That's happiness. This right here, happiness. To be able to just grab things and then when I clean them and I put them here and everybody's gonna know that's where they go. Just make it easy to get my pots and pans. All right, what else could I put down there? Can I put these in here? Or am I pushing it? I think I'm pushing it. Okay, that's not gonna fit there. No, really? fit. Oh my goodness. These pans fit here. We use these a lot. So this would have to be something that we can easily grab. Right? Easily grabbable. Oh yes, look at that. Even though this is on a slant, it doesn't matter. These are always being used to be able to just take them out and throw them in here. It's going to be great. Oh my goodness, why didn't I do this before? Okay. And getting rid of these pans out of the oven helps so much because when I cook, my counter space ends up being my pot and pans place. Right? So my counters become cluttered with all the pans that I take out of the oven and put on the counter. You understand? Okay. Now, let's see if this works. Is this gonna happen? Is it gonna happen? Is this doable? Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Now all I have is a wok in there. And I could put that in my pantry, but we use it a lot too. And it's okay to be in there. Honestly, I had no idea it was going to be that good. Really did not. And I want to keep, I could take that extra burner, you know, the stove burner that's down there. This one here is raised higher for my canners, and that's why I use that. But with me, if I take that burner out of the bottom of the stove, I'm going to forget about it. I'm going to forget where I put it. And so to keep it where it belongs with my stove under my oven, that is something beneficial to me. Like, I need to keep it there, and I know that about me. So whatever you know about yourself, keep your stuff where you know if you're gonna go look for it, or if you even forgot you had it, that you would know it's there if you thought about, oh, if I went to get my old burner, where would I look for that? Well, I would look in the drawer underneath the stove. That's where I would look. Okay, oh my goodness. All right, it's already 1 o'clock in the afternoon, but you know what? Oh my gosh, and I have a headache today. Woke up with a headache yesterday, and I thought, how am I going to do this with a headache? It's not too bad, but I'm still trucking on. It's not like I feel like doing this, but just getting that one closet done, it's just making me feel so good. Honestly, making me feel so good. And I've got a whole box. Oh, camera's looking up at the ceiling. Look at this box of garbage. My pots. Pans. Not pot. Okay, so now I'm trying to think whether I should keep going bottom across or if I should stay over here and tackle the top. Because I know that the drawers are not that bad. There are some things that I need to go through on the drawers down here. On these drawers down here, they're not going to be too bad of a tackle. So this is where I got to make the decision. And you can say, oh my gosh, just do it. You know what? These decisions for me, especially when I have a headache and I'm trying to like deal and do video at the same time and to encourage you to do this with me. Making these decisions sometimes hurt. So I know that the difficult task is gonna be this cupboard. This cupboard didn't have anything in it when I first moved in. I had organized and planned my whole kitchen because I designed it. I designed that there was gonna be a drawer here. I designed that there was going to be these cupboards with the pull-out drawers here and here. I designed that there was going to be garbage here. I designed that there was going to be a small drawer on top. I designed this kitchen in this space. And I knew, I kind of pre-planned some things. Some things I had to change once I moved in because I realized that my cabinets, on my top cabinets and my pantry cabinets, were only 11 inches deep. 11 inches. Who has cabinets that are only 11 inches deep? I mean, at least 12 inches, right? No, 12 inches to the outside of the cabinet. 12 inches to here. 11 inches in the inside. Makes it difficult buying storage containers because a lot of storage containers are 11 point something or 12 inches. But in order to get something that fits in 11 inches, I need a 10 inch or a 10 and a half. Like they really, you don't even, I can't even find 10 and a half inches. I'm getting 10 inch or 11.2, right? 11.2 means that sometimes the doors stay a little tiny bit open and I don't like that. They gotta be closed flat. So I had no idea that my inner shelving on all of my upper cabinets and pantry cabinets were 11 inches interior. Anyways, back to the story of this cupboard had nothing in it. I just put some tea and stuff, okay? That was 5 years ago. I want to look at it now. You don't want to see this. You don't want to see this. No, you don't. You really don't want to see this. You don't. You don't. Okay, there's my stool. Like, just go like this and say, no, don't show me. Anybody else have a cupboard like this? Look at this. Look at this. Look at this. Because I don't have a place to put all my dried herbs and stuff in the kitchen. My dried tea. This here is very handy for me. It needs to be in this cupboard. This is flour and cornstarch. So when I'm making gravies, I know, oop, I take that out of there. So that's got to stay. I've got so much in here. I got my cookbooks. This is my bread maker book. These are my essential books that I use and I grab on a regular basis. So I put them here. But it's really filled up. And I've got to figure out, some of this stuff has got to go. I've got so many tea and coffee strainers that I could probably open a tea shop, I don't know. And I've got to figure this all out. What I'll do, I know what I'll do. Okay. I'm gonna take all this stuff and put it on my other counter because my other counter should be cleared. I'll put it over here. Put it in front of my stuff here. So I'll take everything off the counter here. I'm gonna put it on the other counter. I'm gonna take everything down and then I'm just gonna put in the cupboard what I wanna keep. I don't think there's anything in here though that's garbage. That's the only thing. I'm gonna have to figure something else out for tea. And I've been standing in front of this open cupboard many times, just staring at it, trying to visualize what to do. And I haven't come up with any ideas yet. To be honest, I have not come up with any ideas that work for me. So here goes. This is for you. Helps to freshen breath, mix into cat's drinking water. Trust me, nothing helped my cat's breath. This is just going on garbage. I forgot about this. This is my rose petal tea. It was in the back of that pushback behind everything. And see, if I had it there and I opened it up and I went, oh, that's a good idea. I should have some rose petal tea. Anybody ever have this? Any of you preppers out there? This, I don't know how old this is. 1996 to 2003. Windows 98, NTME 2000 XP. So this is good for Windows up to XP. I should see if this is, I don't know if I ever used it, but it is recipes for food storage or add your own, create a monthly menu plan and print ingredients shopping list. For preparedness software for easiest way to plan, budget, rotate, and use your food storage. Let's check it out. See what that... Just having my menu planner for this week. So this is the first week that we're on menu planner. And the reason why I had those chickpeas going is because I have on my menu planner last night to put them and soak them. Otherwise, I would have forgotten about it. And another thing I want to say. When you start doing something like this, especially in your kitchen, and a kitchen is a place where you prep your meals, already have a plan for your meals. So if you know you're going to be doing this, everyone's going to be in here for lunch, and then you're going to have dinner ready and all that stuff, plan around that. Already have a plan to say, I know I'm going to be doing this, things are going to be hectic for me in the kitchen, but I still got to make lunch, I still got to make dinner. Have it pre-planned. Even if it's buying fast food for that night, do it. But have it pre-planned so that you don't have that extra stress and anxiety in your head going, oh my gosh, I got to get this cleaned up so I can get dinner done, right? This is apple vinegar that I made a couple years ago, and it's really not very strong at all. I tasted it when I started making, I was testing my apple cider vinegar made from apple cider compared to this apple vinegar that was made from chopped up apples. You know, they call it apple cider vinegar, but it's not apple cider vinegar, it's apple vinegar. When you chunk up apples and you put it in water with sugar and stuff and you make vinegar out of it, yeah, that's what this is. And it's very watery compared to regular vinegar. And also my apple cider vinegar is a little bit stronger than this right now. So I keep this for a very mild, mellow vinegar, but that's why it's up in that cupboard up there. So what I'm thinking right now is that anything that I have to store that I don't use but I want to keep, I'm going to put behind there. And there may be things from other cupboards that I would put back there. Because if I don't see it, I don't use it. But if I know that it's there, then that'll be okay. And then these teas that we do use, chamomile flower, lemon balm, elderberry flower, rose petal. And okay, these are dried herbs. What is this? And my apple vinegar, I found a bottle for it. So what I'm going to do so that we start using it, because it's way up in the cupboard and I would never really think of it and to take it down, I'm going to dispense it into this bottle and then we'll use it more often. I might actually fit up there. I don't know. No. But even if I put it on the counter with my stuff here, we'll use it more often. So that's what I'm going to do. Okay, so this ended up being, we were smelling this. I brought it to my daughter and she was with me when we bought it, and it was from the bulk barn, and it's a smell of currant, and it also has fruit flavoring in it, but it's hibiscus, rose, and currant tea, and that was a loose tea from the bulk barn. So I forgot we had this, and I'm gonna put it up here. Also with the stevia, I'm thinking, when I use loose teas and I don't want to put honey or sugar in it, I'll put a leaf or two of stevia just to sweeten it up a bit. And I find it doesn't leave that like horrible green aftertaste, but it does sweeten it slightly. So I'll try that again. All right. Now these little decanters for oil and vinegar, or for vinegars, I'm going to keep them, because I can see myself using them. These extra tea decanters, I know I have tons left in a drawer that I have to declutter, I'm going to put these in a bin, and I got a little bucket, and I'm going to put them up behind there. And if I have extra teapots, if I'm not using teapots, like I've got this beautiful teapot, if I'm not using them, then I'll put them up there. Okay, how glad am I that I didn't throw that out? It actually goes in this teapot. Okay, so actually, I'm always trying to look for a place to put our teapot so we could just grab them when we want them. And I never had a real good spot for it, but this would encourage us to do that. So I'm going to put it there, and there's enough room here for it. So I'm happy about that. And these little doodads go with ground coffee. So these sometimes get a little wet, so I might have a little tray to put those in. Other than that, I think everything looks really good. I think that looks pretty darn good, if I do say so myself. I'm coming back. Felina's right here, so she's gonna wanna eat you. You guys stay back. I have to watch my cats don't get out here. There you go, honey. That's it for today. Okay? Alright, I got that cupboard done. That cupboard done. Under here done. I was about to move on to another section, and I remembered this drawer. Oh! Wait a sec. Look at this. Look at this. Well, you want to know a funny story. Oh, this is a wine cork opener that we have. And I don't really like using this one. I don't know why. I just don't trust it very much. I think it's because my husband used something like this once years ago, and it broke and it came apart, and he ended up almost slicing his finger off. And I don't know. I just don't like them. But I like these ones, right? And they're safer to me. Well, we were in this drawer about a week or two ago, and I was fishing through things, and lo and behold, up here somewhere, I found this and this. And I was like, oh my goodness, said to my daughter, look at these. I totally forgot I had these. This one is like a heavy duty one. I paid some good money for that. It's even weighs a good weight. And totally did not know and forgot that I had them, because they were literally lost in here. This right here, Bermuda Triangle, where things go missing. And it's just because of the chaos. So I am going to attempt to declutter this, and anything that's rusty too that I don't want, I'll just buy something new. I'm trying to figure out how to organize this, because there are like things like here, this is my wok spoon here, and it's really long and it can fit a certain way, but I think if I had, like I have shorter things that go along the bottom, and I'm thinking of having a divider here, but then if I had a divider, this wouldn't fit. Like there's not much room here. There's only like an inch and a half left. And trying to figure out how to do this drawer. So this is the beginning, and I'll show you the end. I'm gonna put everything up here, declutter everything that I don't want or I have too many of, and then I'll go from there. Anyways, these I can get rid of. This one I'm going to donate, because I have that other big one. I'll donate this one. This one, I don't know. Needles. So I've got enough room for everything, but to me it still looks pretty cluttered. Now, if this had dividers in here where all my spatulas were together, all of my wooden spoons, so I would put like all my spatulas together, I would stack all of my spoons. And this is how this drawer got sorted out. It's working really well. All of my whisks are here. They don't move. This stays pretty organized on a regular basis. I'm taking this video a month after. So I'm just telling you that this is what's in here. This is what works. My large, that's for my wok down there. It goes from here to here, so it's the whole length. And then my large spoons, they all work down here. And then all of these fit into these containers. And I've got my little gravy. This is for, right? So all of that fits in here nicely, all the pieces of it. You know, I got my thermometers and my gauges and all that in here. Gravy ladles. These are my rice things for my Instant Pot. My baster, my tiny, tiny whisks. Very, very easy to open this. I know where everything is before I'm even going to open it. I know where to look. It's not a big mess anymore. And these containers here are a larger, thicker container. They're the same containers that I use in my pantry. And that video will come at a much later date. That's my whole kitchen pantry, which is over there. Yeah, and so they work really well in here. Nothing moves. I have the liner on the bottom, but it's just so, so easy, convenient. Everything that I have in here, I use. Everything that I don't use or was old, or I tossed out, I got rid of. If it was still good, then I donated it. And here are some of my before pictures. Just everything cluttered and messy, and my after. Ta-da! Yay! Love it. Now, I was looking at these here. This is for my canner, and I keep it here all the time so I don't lose it. That is my non-iodized salt. It's actually canning salt, and I grind it down, and I leave it in here. This is iodized salt in my pepper shaker. My timer, which I use. This here is for oven. Now, you know what? I can't remember the last time I've used that, but I'll leave it there in case I need it. And I find, I got this rack here. It was a prize for something. I don't know what it was. Prize for something. And I was going to re-gift it and that. And then I thought, at one point, I opened it up and I was like, oh, it's magnetic. What can we do with that? And I put it up here as a tray to put like a salt pepper shaker on there and stuff. And it was perfect. It's perfect for me just to like have a shelf for stuff, because this here is just, I mean, things will slide off of it. Actually, I should just wipe that down now that I have it out. Now, these are empty. I never use them. And look at how greasy and dusty they get. I don't like them at all. And I don't use them for anything. They just take up space. I will use this for pepper. Oh, I could put that there. But I don't use the salt one. I think I'm gonna toss this. So I don't need it. Okay, the counter space. I'm looking at this and I'm thinking. That's our go-to tea. This is for all of our loose teas. And I'm thinking, oh, I could put this in my cupboard with my loose teas now, so I don't need to have it here. So that's out of the way. And then coffee. These are our, just, I'm going to put this away. But I could put that in the tea cupboard now. Keep it off the counter. Now, I don't mind that on the counter. It might go back on the counter, but if I don't have to have it there, then I won't. Now, what I need room for is these. This is honey and sweetener. That's erythritol. I could put this here. I just don't like it. I just don't like that. To me, it's not aesthetically pleasing. It's bothering me. I need something else here. Anyways, The fact that I got the tea out of there and the tea sifters or whatever you call them, tea strainers. And again, when I get to that closet there, that is a whole nother story. Now let's look at this disaster. This is a disaster. It's a bunch of vases, a bunch of liquor bottles. Oh, I got extra tea out there. I'm just gonna take everything out and just go from there. We don't come up in this closet very much. Yeah, we have alcohol, but we don't drink a lot. When we got married, we made our own wine, and we had tons of booze left over because we catered our own wedding. And what was already open for the open bar, the bottles that were already open of liquor, we couldn't return. But the stuff that was closed, we were able to return to the liquor store. But all the open bottles, we had to keep. And 6 years later, we still had wine left over from our wedding. We just kept bringing it to our family or friends, and whenever we'd visit or have dinner or whatever, we just keep bringing it to them because we just didn't drink a lot. So I'll leave my vases up here. I think these are the ones that I'm keeping. I like this one because it has a medium top on it. This one's kind of big. I don't know about that one. This one I like. The only other one that I would keep would be this red one. The other ones I'm donating. I probably don't even need these ones. So I kept this red one. I don't really reach up there for anything anyways. Like, I'm not that tall and I wouldn't be doing that. So those are just kind of put away things. If I know my vases are up there, then I know they're up there. Now this cupboard is not working for us. Not working. Now, I put supplements up here because they were on the counter and just taking up space, so I put them up here. And the butter has to go up here. I don't know why people keep leaving the knife in there. But the butter has to go up here, and I was keeping it in a canning jar. And then I started putting it on a plate. I think that's a mistake. I think I have to go back to the jar. Butter has to go up there because our cat will eat the butter if it's on the counter. And yeah, I've got to come up with something else here. This isn't working, so I'm decluttering. This cupboard had sugar bowls that didn't have lids, extra butter dishes, extra teapots, cups and glasses that we didn't even use anymore. And I just took them all out. Some of them got donated and the others just went in the garbage. What I decided to do here was that all the front row was all the cups and glasses that we use every day. And then things that we don't always use got put either up higher and towards the back. So it is 5 o'clock. I've got clean counters. Look at this corner. I have these drawers, these cupboards done, all my pots and pans, this tea cupboard, I guess I could call it, beautifully organized and labeled. The back of my stove is all decluttered and cleaned up. Above the stove, everything's done. Now this corner, look at this, there's nothing on here. There's only a kettle and a toaster. And a place for my coffee and honey up there. Everything is absolutely fabulous. I love it. I am no way a minimalist. I'm going to show you what happens to this countertop later. But for now, these drawers have to be done. And I'm going to tackle some of this stuff later on tonight. Alrighty then. It is 5 o'clock. And I thought I was gonna quit earlier because I had a headache. I took a couple of Tylenol, but I sat down, we had lunch, and then I just kept going with the rest of the cupboards here. Now it's 5 o'clock and I'm feeling a little bit tired. I'm not overwhelmed at all. I just feel like I'm behind. I feel like I haven't gotten a lot done. But if you see my hallway, my foyer, of everything I've thrown out and what I'm donating, and if I look at my cupboards and I go, oh wow, not only that, but just when I asked my daughter, said, open the oven, and she saw, she was, all I see is a wok. I go, yeah, where's all of our pans? And she started looking around. She's like, oh, it fits here, fits here. And then she thought that the cast iron might have been in the pantry. I said, no, it's not there, because we would not put our cast iron in the pantry. We would walk all the way over to a hallway to get a pan, right, for cooking. But then she turned around, she looked, and then she went to the bottom part of the oven, that drawer, and she saw them there, and she's like, oh, they fit. She goes, well, that's where they should be. So that made me feel good when she said, well, yeah, that's where they should be. That's where they belong, right? So that's really good. So I got everything tidied up and cleaned up here. I got this drawer done. I'm going to see what kind of either containers or dividers I could put in here. The fact that I got this cupboard done with all of the coffee cups, and trying to figure out like where to put the butter. I took a glass dish that actually holds a whole pound of butter, and I'm like, you know what? I'm just gonna keep that there because it fits there now, because I declutter a lot of these cups. I'm only keeping the cups that we use all the time here. Some of the extras I put up in the back of the next shelf up there. And then I put the coffee and the honey. I ended up putting the honey in this, which I can fill up anytime. I can even put a bigger container than this and fill up, and that'll be easy for us to switch out and refill. So that's just up there. And to be able to keep the counter down here minimal and decluttered, to be able to put that coffee and honey somewhere was a big deal for me, and the butter always had to go up here. So I'm gonna tell you, this counter was always had all of our vitamins. It had our sweetener, it had our honey, it had two kinds of coffee, it had tea strainers, and it had tea strainer holders. This whole countertop here was full all the time, and I hated it. I hated looking at it. I hated being able, like, coming here and cooking and just this counter always having so much stuff on it, and now it doesn't. And it's functional, and it's very easy for the rest of the family to remember where everything goes, because you just open the cupboard and it's like coffee, butter, supplements. Very easy to see. And everything else that's behind, like I had stacks of water glasses here and stacks of wine glasses, but I don't need them there. I put them along the back because those extra water glasses and the wine glasses, we don't use very often. And so these water glasses here, they're always stacked, but I don't use them. My husband uses them, and just to have them up here and just right there out in the open, take them from the dishwasher, put them up on the front layer. Everything that's on the front layer are things that we use. The things that we don't use as many of would be put behind. So the extra coffee mugs, the extra water glasses, and I'm talking about, you know, nice water glasses, and our wine glasses, we put up in the back two rows. So I think this is going to be quite functional, and I'm really pleased with the progress. Now, it's 5 o'clock, just after 5, and being on some extra strength Tylenol is kind of getting me a little tired, but I am going to try my best to finish at least this side of the kitchen. Going through these drawers down here is going to be a task. This one is going to be a big declutter. This one is going to be a declutter and an organization. The bottom one I'm not going to worry about too much because it's functional. But you know, as much as we'd love to be the Bionic Woman or Superwoman, or no, Superman, because some of you guys out there are doing this in your homes too. Hey, it's just not all the girls, right? Some of you guys out there, we're not all Superman, we're not Wonder Woman, and we're not the Bionic Woman, where we go really fast, for all of you use that were like children in the 70s. Remember the Bionic Woman? My favorite TV show. you know, we're not speedy like that. I can speed things up on camera afterwards when I'm editing, but that's not real. So right now I'm kind of tired. Take your time, pace yourself. Look at what you've already done and say, wow, good job. Go look in the mirror and say, hey, high five, good job. Tell yourself you've done a really great job. And then as I go and rest for a little bit, drink some water. Like I was saying, drink some water, change my camera battery. I almost lost all of that footage, but I saw that the battery was flashing as I was looking at the camera there, and I was actually, it actually saved what I was filming. So anyways, I'm gonna go sit down, take a break. Like this, watch a motivational video, okay? Watch something that's saying, hey, somebody else is doing this, this is good. Hey, maybe those are good ideas. Maybe that's what I should do with my cupboard, or that's an idea for my pantry or my drawers. Anyways, I've got a mess here to do. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go take a break and I'm gonna think about it. I'm gonna think about the next step that I'm gonna do. And when I have the rebuilt energy to do it, I'm gonna do it. Supper tonight, remember I said make your meals simple when you're doing jobs like this, because if I had to make a big meal, if I didn't take things out, if I didn't pre-plan, I'd be like, oh my gosh, what am I gonna do for dinner now? Now, tonight it's just me and my daughter, she's an adult, but we have our menu planner already spilled out, so all I gotta do is get this Instant Pot on. We're gonna make some rice. I made chickpeas already today. I made them this morning because I soaked my beans last night because my menu planner told me to, reminded me to do that. And I've got a jar of sauce, and I also have either chicken broth, and I can add chicken to it, leftover chicken from yesterday's meal. So we're gonna have butter chicken with some frozen peas. So that's all gonna go basically really quickly for dinner when we're hungry. And so I'm gonna think about that. And then I'm gonna come and putter around, and I'll put the camera on, and I'll declutter this horrible drawer of a mess. I mean, this is chaos. Look at this. Look at this. This is something I just can't stand anymore. And I almost went through cleaning it a couple of days ago, and I said, nope, gotta wait for the video. Yes, I said, I've got to wait for the video, because if I have everything already cleaned up, what kind of decluttering and cleaning video am I going to have? So I left it, but I already kind of know some of the things that I want to do here. Not only that, but now that I have my cupboard with all the tea and everything done, there are certain things that I know where they can go now that don't have to be in this drawer. And I know what I have because I've been through everything. And make me dark again. So I know what I have, and I know what I can toss out from this drawer. So that's gonna be good. I don't think this is gonna be too difficult. So I'll be back. Keep going. You're doing a great job. If you're working along with me, just remember you're doing awesome. Every little thing. If you just put five things away, if you just did one drawer, one cupboard, one shelf, you're one step farther than you were before you did it, right? Okay, here we go. This has been such a disaster zone. All of this full and all of this full. And, you know, now I've got this going on the top up there, right? So when I get up tomorrow and I come to make my coffee and everything is just so easy to grab. Here we go, no lighting again. Everything I have that's easy to grab, I'll be really happy with myself. So, On to day two. Congratulations if you stuck with me this far. Today is day two. Clean with me.
Okay, so last night I finished the top drawer, which is good, and now I'm on to this one. This is where I keep all of my strainers. There's some bakeware in here that doesn't need to be in here anymore. That's for my hamburger buns. There's silicone molds for baking. I've got cutting boards in here. Some of them fit in here, some don't. I have pieces for my food processor, just all kinds of everything. And there's things in here that I didn't even know were in here, like my skewers. And if you don't know that they're in here, you can't find them, you can't use them. I got a rolling pin in here, just all kinds of stuff. So I got sprouting lids. I've got my trivets and my scale, just all kinds of stuff. So what I'm doing is I'm just taking everything out. All of my baking pans are going to go, all my silicone pans are going to go into my pantry because I already organized that and there's room in there for that. I have a container that holds them all. And then I'm going to totally organize this drawer, and I have some containers that work really well in here. Although these cutting boards fit in here, they hide everything, and I need to see what I have and be able to grab it easily. So this is where they're going. See? Looks much better. Okay, you're still here. So this is the junk drawer. Everybody has one. All I'm doing here is taking everything out, and I'm only putting back in this drawer what I need. All the duplicates and all the garbage, everything's coming out and it's not going back in. And then what I do want, I want it organized. Okay, so this is all the stuff that needs to either be rehomed or need to ask my husband about. So that doesn't need to be in the drawer at all. This is the final. So these are all my bottle and gadget brushes. These are for my hummingbirds. They're gonna go out in the spring, and I just leave them there. My string. These are all the rest of my... I'm going to talk about why I got black. I'm going to tell you guys later. And I also got these scrubbies by Skoy, and they're working out really well. I'll talk about those another time. Put our gloves here so we could just grab them as we need them. I wasn't sure about taking them out of the box. I was kind of afraid, but I think this is going to work fine. They're just for cooking. And these are things for the kitchen tap, the repairs. So it's a good thing to keep them here. And yeah, these are just handy tools that I know that they're in here. This is kind of like the junk drawer. And I like that these fit in here, and I was able to have space on the side for the couple of long gadgets. And yeah, this is going to be easy to find things. Well, it worked out pretty good. It was easy. 5 minutes. Thank you very much. Okay, under the sink here. Now, I have to admit, this looks worse than it really is, especially the left side here, because we just tossed everything in here after we had some water leaking under the sink. What happened was the handle of our tap was broken, and we replaced it. We thought we fixed it, but it ended up leaking under the sink, and it stayed wet in there for probably about a week or two. It did a little bit of damage on the base of the cupboards under here, where, you know, that laminate is a little bit lifted, and one of the
rings around the pipes is kind of rusted. So anyways, I'm just cleaning this all out again, and I realized that the base of the cabinet here was kind of lifted. I decided to put a liner down.
Okay, so I've got different scrubbies and J cloths and stuff in here. And this one has a lid on it. Oh. And then I put my extra, I just got rubbing alcohol. I don't even really use this stuff. It came as like one of those giveaways at the grocery store when you buy so many groceries and they give you a bunch of stuff. Pretty sure that was in it, or else maybe I did try it by ordering it on Amazon, not sure. These here are my cleaning scrub brushes. These are not for the kitchen. These are for things like if I'm cleaning the bird bath or I'm doing other stuff. Outside the home, I got cleaning vinegar, Smith's pads, and then the grill cleaner for the barbecue. So these are things that don't really use on a regular basis. I've got my a little bin back there with, I think that was the stuff from the dishwasher, installing the dishwasher parts. So I just leave it back there. And then I have these produce bags that I used for my juicer. I would line my juicer with that. So I just covered them over so they don't get wet, because I'm going to put my sink drainer on there. I don't leave this in the sink. I use it in the sink, but then I store it under here like that. Now, what I used to have here was my dish rack, and I don't use my dish rack. And I thought, well, I'll keep it here, and I'll see if I use it, and if I never use it, then it's going in the garbage. But I kept it just in case. And then these are just different rags and scrubbies that I use for, like, maybe wiping the floor and stuff. So I don't keep them with my dishcloths. And then we've got rubber gloves and a scrubby. So it just kind of stays there and houses those things. And then the cat food. Cat food always goes here when we fill their bowls. And this is my cleaning bin. So these are things we use regularly. Window cleaner, my Sani Blend, Lysol if I ever need it. I got this. My mom never used this. This was at her apartment when she had a dishwasher, and I will try using it just to use it up, but, or maybe for cleaning the dishwasher. I don't know. Just some extra Lysol wipes. I know where they are when they're here. That's kind of like for the garbage can when I'm wiping out the bottom of the garbage can. And then I have my barkeeper's friend. This is the powder. This is the liquid part. I like this one better. And then I just keep SOS pads there, and then that's our dishwasher tabs. And we just keep refilling this with dishwasher tabs. But we're used to that, just coming, opening the cupboard, grabbing one, and leaving them there. And then I found this. Oh, this was in one of those giveaways that you get when you buy groceries. And it's to clean your dishwasher every once in a while. So I'm just going to leave that right here, because that's for the dishwasher. Actually, I think what I'll do here, since I have this in a bin, and I don't use those produce bags a lot anymore, I'll keep these sponges here. Let those dry out a bit. And then I'll just keep this scrubby over here. That's what I use, like, to clean the stove and that when I need to. And when we have to grab gloves, my daughter will grab them out of here. If we don't need them, I'll just take them out, and we use this in our sink for vegetables and different things when we're cooking. So I think that's good. That's good and simple. All right. And here is the drying rack that I haven't used in like 5 years. Never needed it, really. Got used to just, if we hand washed anything, like big bowls and stuff, they wouldn't fit in here anyways. I had a very small counter space in my old house, and that was out on the counter constantly, always air drying dishes. And so if we have to air dry something, we just use the drying mats. So this is a bye-bye. That's going in the trash. And yeah, so that'll clean that out. It's good. And just pick what I need out of here. So if we need this strainer, we just pull it in, put it on top. We always store the gloves in there, and any of my kitchen stuff that I need to use, my cat food, I just pull it out and refill their bowls. So that's very neat and tidy now.
I spent some time measuring my utensil drawer where we keep our forks and knives and all of our little gadgets. And we don't have straight sides on our drawers. They're bowed. They're plastic. They are not IKEA. And it was kind of hard looking and finding the proper size containers. And I tried to get the least expensive that was out there. And so this is me playing some Tetris. This drawer needed help desperately. So when I bought these containers, I knew that they would fit in a certain way, but I wasn't exactly sure because of the bowed ends on these drawers, like the sides of them bow in. And I needed two long containers, one to fit my steak knives and one that would fit things like chopsticks that are long. And for some reason, I couldn't figure it out here. It wasn't working for me. What I do in the end, though, is I take the chopsticks out and I roll them up, and I'll show you later on. And the steak knives fit in that one container perfectly, and it all works out. But I line the drawer here, and then I start putting all the containers in and putting all the utensils in and figuring it all out with what I have. And basically, all you can do is start trying to make things fit. Now, these chopsticks gave me such a hard time because I really needed that size container for my steak knives. What I ended up doing with those chopsticks was putting a slap band on them, and they went up the side of the drawer. And I ended up using that container for steak knives after, and you'll see in the end how it works out. All my little gadgets, everything fit perfectly. I end up tossing out some things that I don't use anymore, that were garbage, that were just hanging around and taking up space. And this awful plastic thing, I could finally throw out. It just was not working for us anymore. And voila, look at that, perfect. A place for everything and everything in its place. And the drawer underneath is where we keep all of our dishes, right beside the dishwasher, perfect place. And we keep our bread board here also. And the last drawer is my Tupperware drawer, and this only took me about 10 minutes. I just took out everything that didn't belong. If there was mismatches, something was cracked, I didn't use it anymore, or if it was too stained, I just threw them out. And this one was an easy one. And we finally come to the end of a very long video, but the end of a very long 2 days of working on this project. I am so happy with everything that resulted from this. Everything is easy to find, easy to clean, and easy to put away. And I can say it really changes the atmosphere working in a kitchen like this now. Some things are very difficult to do, very difficult to start. But when we take the time to help one another and we put in that effort, we benefit from it in the end. I hope that people who need somebody to encourage them, to work along with them, to be a body double for the clean with me, organize with me, declutter with me type videos, that somebody gets a benefit from this video. And for now, I hope you have a wonderful day, and I'll see you on the next video.